Hello, I'm Snobby Refined. Welcome to Reese's Peace Theater on WJMR. Well, this is a little segment that we have in between segments of Express Yourself. And I thought we'd take some letters from our audience out there in TV land.
All right, this is from Bobb from San Francisco.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Director. Ex-director. Dear Snob Edified. That's me. I love your show very much. I also love your time slot a lot more. In fact, I love it so much that I want it. I know where you live, and I know your name, and I also know where you live. Sincerely, P.S. I'm not really Bob, I'm somebody else, but I can't really read the handwriting. Now that is a threat letter. I shall not tolerate it. Who threw that?
All right. And we're clear.
Yeah.
There's somebody to see you.
All right, I'll be right there. Hello, I'm Snobby. Hi, may I help you, sir?
Yeah, I was watching your show be taped today. It's a real shame about that guy who wants your time slot. Mm-hmm. You know, I think I know who that Bob guy is.
Really, who?
He's me. Kill him, Mike!
It's the wonderful world of Dick, Jane, and Spot. All your favorite children's choices are coming to video cassette in four wonderful tapes. The Wonderful World of Dick, Jane, and Spot, The Wonderful World of Dick, The Wonderful World of Jane, and The Wonderful World of Spot. Let's review some of that, shall we? See Dick. See Dick run. See Dick ride. See Dick park. Park Dick park. See Dick climb. See Dick jump. See Dick fall. See the chair fall on top of Dick. See Dick's funeral. Goodbye, Dick. Call toll-free 1-800-SEA-DICK or send $15.95 per month to Fun Game, 1234 South Dickinson Street, Yorktown, USA, plus $3 for postage and handling.
Hello, I'm Bob Bill, and this is a Winter TV news update. During the taping of the Winter TV-sponsored show, Reese's Peace Theater, the host of the show, Snobby Refine, received a threat letter. Immediately after the taping of the show, the writer of the threat letter came to the studio and reportedly attacked Mr. Refined. They are both due to appear in court right after this news broadcast.
This is the plaintiff, Snob E. Refined. He is charging the defendant with battery and trespassing. He's suing for $2,000 to boot his new show. This is the defendant, a man they call Mr. Bob. He is charged with trespassing and battery. The court session you are about to see is fake. The people are just dumb, moronic actors whining and moaning about one idiotic thing after another. They've reluctantly given up the attention of the Supreme Court and have agreed to settle it in our forum. The Moron's Court.
All rise for the
respected Judge Wiggums. I'm sorry, everybody. My glasses. I'm sorry, everybody. You know, I'm legally blind. Can I get my Wiggum dog? Sorry to excuse all your time, everybody, but I'm legally blind, and I can't see a darn thing. Now, what's your story, Mr. Didn't catch your name.
They call me Mr. Bobb.
That's a strange last name.
I am Snobby Refined.
I understand that you don't really have a British accent.
You don't really have a Southern accent, do you, either?
Well, that is very untrue. Rumors about that, if I may. I don't know where people get the idea of me, you know, not having a British accent. I mean, it's quite foolish, isn't it? But the only person...
Shut up! Got the fuck.
Well, you didn't let me finish.
I know. That was our point. Now, Mr. Bob, what did your letter say on it to Mr. Refine?
It simply said that I was hoping to have a chance to meet him and get his talk about getting his time slot.
Remember, you're under oath. Now to tell the truth.
But I must ask you, Your Honor, what is the truth?
Excuse me, I'm over here.
Objection!
Overruled. All right, Mr. Bailiff. Would you please give Mr. Refine the letter?
Yes, Your Honor. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, the reason why I am wearing this old Cub Scout uniform is that this morning when I was eating, I spilled some crud. Washed. That's why I'm wearing this wonderful blue Cub Scout uniform from when I was a boy myself. And now, Your Honor, Mr. Refine, I'll give you the paper with the letter. Oh, some threat letter, Mr. Refine, eh? Here you go.
The letter clearly states, "Dear Snobby Refined."
Excuse me. I see the words PTO printed on the back.
How would you know? You're not supposed to see through paper.
He's lying.
It says, "Dear Mr. Refined." Actually, it says, "Dear Snobby Refined, I love your show very much, and I also love your time slot. In fact, I want it. I know where you live, and I know your name, and I know where you live. Sincerely, Bob."
Overruled! charged in this kind of court.
I'm totally sorry, Your Honor.
No pornography.
Shut up.
Mr. Bobb, what do you have to say for this?
I'm gonna kill you.
I don't allow that kind of language in this courtroom. No pornography.
I'm gonna kill you.
No pornography.
You're gonna die.
No pornography. Stop it. No pornography.
I'll show you. I'll show you what's overruled. Now you're gonna die.
Why don't you come up here and join your little friend?
Excuse me, I'm Judge Wiggums. Stop it! Mr. Happy, what do you have to say for this?
Love and love.
All right, Mr. Bob. What do you have to say for this?
I see you're gonna die!
No, Bob, no pornography!
No,
no
pornography! Jerry! Jerry, help me!
Go, man, be
gone! Go, man! Go, go, go!
Come on!
Oh, man! Ooh, that head hurt! Oh, man!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh.
Ah, the guy's eye! Oh. Oh. Oh, my God! Ew, blood all
over,
over the place!
Over.
Oh, my God!
Snobby,
refined, he's pretty cool, isn't he?
Yeah,
what
yeah,
do you
yeah.
Mean,
Mr.
Bob, man,
Mr.
Bob's
yeah,
beating
yeah,
him
yeah.
up.
Okay, come on, Mr.
Yeah,
Bob, come
yeah,
on.
Yeah,
go.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
oh,
my God.
Come on, Mr.
Oh.
Judge. Oh, man.
$20
oh.
Snobby, refined,
right? You're on, man. It's Bob, man. Yeah. All the way.
I've got something else I gotta bid.
There you go.
All right.
All right, man. I got I'm in.
Winner takes all, man. Hello, I'm Robert Williams, and this is a Winner TV News Update. After receiving a threat letter and being attacked by its writer, Snobby Refine, the host of the Winner TV-sponsored show Reese's Peace Theater, appeared in court as the plaintiff with his stalker and rival, a man they called Mr. Bobb. The court session ended as a fiasco when Mr. Bobb reportedly attacked both Judge Wiggums and Mr. Refine. He was sentenced to 3 years in Waupun State Correctional Facility. Bail is set at $27. More updates will take home. Stay tuned for the fastest man in the world and his sidekick, Skippy.
Dang! I've been walking forever, and I still haven't found anything.
It had been 5 days since Skippy was separated from his partner, the fastest man in the world. He'd been walking ever since then.
Whoa! Finally, civilization! Man, oh, all these things up. Get up. As long as I'm in civilization. I think around here is our old secret hideout. I'll go over here and look for it, because there's a peep.
No! Our old secret hideout! No!
No!
Look at what they've done. Our hoses,
boxes, our wood collection. I'm gonna find them. I'm gonna find them. Best man, if you can hear me, whoever did this, I'm gonna find you. And me, and the fastest man in the world. I'm gonna find you. Our only remaining wall. Hey, what's that? But hey, wait. That box house wasn't there before. I think I'll go and investigate. All this stuff. This could be master. Not a fresh scent. Doesn't look all that weird. Wonder what this means. I think I'll look through these. I can't see anything. Just the other side. And some stuff up there. Weird. I wonder what this means. I remember seeing some stuff over here. Let's go. Remember a hose coming through our house, but this smells like gas. A weird kind of gas. The fastest man in the world's favorite beverage. And is repellent. They must have used this to capture him. And this to tie him up. All they needed to do is break a tape in there. So what's that? I'll try to find out with my super hearing. Oh, it's just Jeff over there. Hi, Jeff. Jeff, come down here. Ransacked that place over there.
Oh, your secret hideout was wrecked?
Yeah.
Oh, that's too bad. Where's the fastest man in the world?
I think he was caught by the guy who did it. I think the guy has something to do with this building.
Whoa. Come on, let's go take a look inside.
Here's the place.
Yeah.
Well, Skippy, I don't know. It's locked with a deadbolt.
Maybe fastest man in the world is in there.
Fastest man, can you hear us?
Are you okay?
I already looked in there.
I don't see anything in
there's
there.
There's not much.
Whoa. You should see all the cases of stuff that are on a shelf up there. There's like these whole bunch of cases.
Yeah, I know. I saw them already.
Really? You looked in here already?
Yeah.
In here, or is there some other place?
No.
Really? Let me see if there's any other place to look in. So you stay here. See if anything comes up. Well, tell you what I saw. I didn't see cases. I saw a whole bunch of saw blades. Well. I think we should continue our investigation on this.
Sure.
I don't like this.
Yeah, let's get to back to this.
It's too creepy out here. Let's
go. And I'm getting tired. I've been walking 5 days.
Really? Oh, we gotta get you home. Come on, I'll take you to my house.
Yeah.
So, where do you think the guy is who took the fastest man in the world?
I don't know, but I'm gonna find him.
Mr. Bobb, the man who attacked Snobby Refine, was released on bail by Mr. Roy Olson, the owner and president of Winner TV. He's now being offered a job at Winner TV.
You know it's time for Adventures with Gary. And Gary wants to play football, and I asked him, "What is this?" And he said, "Well, it's a vortex." Well, I really wasn't too sure about these new and improved footballs that they were making all the time now. But I tried. I had a hard time getting it in there. Very hard. I said, "Don't go ever back." So, I came back and I couldn't find a hammer, so I had a little hatchet with a hammer end. So I tried to pound the holster on there. I had to get it started a little bit by myself. Yeah, that kind of hurt. Gary was still holding it for me. So, well, I threw the hammer away, and I reared back, and well, I gave it my best kick. That didn't look too appealing. Felt real bad, so I picked up Gary, and so then I gave Gary a chance to kick it. Here he goes. There's the kick. Whoa, not bad for a puppet. Oh, and I caught it. Whoa!
Neil gets it. He's going for it. He's going for it. Yes, he scores. Touchdown! He's doing the Dion. Go, Neil!
Whoa! I was just riding along, minding my own business, when all of a sudden, whoa! Ooh, that looked painful. Thank you.